going on, everybody? I'm back with another video. And a couple days ago, I posted on IG, what are some ways that you guys personally get out of B block? A ton of people commented and shared different ways that they personally get out of B block. And I figured, you know what? Why don't I make a video about how I personally get out of B block? So today I'm gonna show you with you guys 10 different ways that I personally get out of B block. Now I know a lot of people have said in videos that they don't believe in B block, but for me personally, I believe in B block, but I believe it's disguised in many different ways. It could be disguised as you not being focused, you just making the same thing over and over again, you making the same thing with the same sounds, and you already just, you have no feeling to it. You're not even feeling it. You're just like this on the computer. I know a lot of people say, oh, you shouldn't stress out about it, it's not a big deal. But I've been in plenty of situations where I was trying to build with somebody, and finally when it came time for me to pull up to go meet them when they were in town, I was out of it. I was burnt out, I was shocked, I was going through a B block, and like nothing could help me. For some people, they all go through that kind of situation, and at one point in time, you're gonna go through that. It's just a fact of life. So hopefully these tips can help you out. So the first way that I get out of B block is I'll take a day and I'll search through presets. I'll go through all of these VSTs that I have, whether it be Omnisphere, whether it be the Arturia bundle, and then I'll search and find presets and I'll save them. Doing this, you'll find a lot of your unique sounds, and you'll find sounds where you can categorize them. So you can be like, okay, this is a pop sound, so I'm gonna put this in the pop folder. I'll save them in the folder and then I'll just drag them, drop them next time. I mean, it makes sense, because how many times have we been inspired and then we're making something and we spend too much time looking for this certain preset? You'll always feel overwhelmed, so I recommend that you take a day and you do that. And the best thing about that is sometimes you'll find a sound and you'll be like, man, this inspires me right now, I need to make something out of this. So the second way I like to get out of beat block is I like to create playlists. Doing this will help you so much because you can find new things. So whether it be something on SoundCloud that has 100 plays or something on Tidal that has 1 million plays, it doesn't matter. I'll create playlists and I'll always go back to them. I remember one time, right? I was super uninspired and I was just digging through SoundCloud and I found Mike Dean's version of Goosebumps. You know, the live version where he's playing the synths.
I get those goosebumps every time. I need the Heimlich, throw that to the side, yo. I get those goosebumps every time, yeah. When you're not around, when you throw that to the side, yo. I get those goosebumps every
time. And it sounded so amazing to me. I was like, damn, you know what? This got me inspired. I'm gonna download the Arturia bundle. I'm gonna buy it, and then I'm gonna just, you know, make whatever. That created a whole new thing for me. So create some playlists, whether it be small songs, big songs, whatever, and let that inspire you. Now, number three is find new samples. Go on YouTube and just dig. Just get lost in the wormhole of finding new samples. There's plenty of people that have YouTube playlists of samples. So just type in whatever, video game samples playlist, and then you're good. You'll find something new. Speaking of this, I'll give you guys a super clutch gem. Totally off topic, but you know what? It has to do with this one. What I like to do is I like to go to my sample folder of all the samples that I chopped or samples that I've traded with other people, and then I'll grab the name, I'll throw it into YouTube, and I'll find those channel playlists. So just to hook you up, down below, I'm gonna have a link to this like ambient sample pack that's like 2 gigabytes. If you don't know what the demo sample chops are, you know, you're welcome. And if you do know and you already have it, just let people enjoy them. Actually, if you go back and you do the same thing, you might find some new channels. Down below, I'm gonna have some YouTube channels and playlists that you guys can go to, so you guys can download those samples and you guys can get to work. So you guys can never say I never helped you out. The next thing I like to do is I like to find new chord progressions. So I'll go on Google and I'll type in chord progression. Here's some chord progressions that you guys can have, and I promise you, they all sound good. I also like to use the free VST called Chords and link it to whatever VST that I have and just try what works. And if it sounds good, I'll keep it. And if it doesn't, I'll throw it away. The fifth thing I'll do is I'll chunk things. Let me explain. One of my favorite books ever is Tony Robbins' Unlimited Power. As you can see, this book is pretty torn up, but I live and breathe by this book because it changed my life and it changed my way of thinking. And one of the concepts in the book is called chunking. And one of the things that you do is, instead of trying to take this big concept or this big thing that you're trying to do, instead of doing it all at once, break it into pieces, into 4 to 6 pieces, and do it bit by bit. So if you're trying to memorize a word like Albuquerque, instead of trying to memorize the whole thing, saying Albuquerque, 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 split it into three different parts. So how does this apply to production? Well, Monday, you're gonna chop samples, right? Actually, I already gave you the plug, so Monday, you're pretty good. Tuesday, you're gonna try different things of percussion. You know, whether it be drill percussion, whether it be African percussion, it doesn't matter. Just try five different variations, right? Wednesday, kick and snare. Maybe you don't like the basic kick and snare, or maybe you keep making the same basic kick and snare patterns. So you're gonna try some different ones. Thursday, you're gonna do 808s and bass lines. Friday, you're gonna do arrangement. Saturday, you're gonna do mixing. Sunday, you're gonna render it out. You're gonna go to Photoshop, find the photo, brand it, and then throw it up on YouTube or wherever. Send it to somebody. And if you do that, by the end of the week, you should be stacked with a couple beats. So if you're a college student, you're in law school, you have a full-time job, there's really no excuse. So that's chunking. I hope you guys apply that one because that one really helps a lot. So the sixth thing that I do to get out of BeatBlock is I like to go through my old beats and save the drum pattern. I'll save it as a drum loop so that way I could just drag and drop later, or I could use it as a source material, as inspiration. I actually got this gem from Cardiac because he'll go on live and make a whole beat out of a drum loop, and then at the end he'll say, nah, this ain't it, and delete that shit. And I'll be so fucking heated because it'll be fire. But, you know what I'm saying? It is what it is. Oh yeah, make sure you save all your ideas because Vinyls will literally throw out all his beats, and then Boy Wonder will go into the recycling bin, take them out, and make a hit out of them. And yeah, if he would have deleted them, they would never be hits. And you'd be surprised what beats became hits. So save your ideas. Now the seventh thing that I like to do is I like to take a day and just create a whole bunch of loops for a rainy day. I'll be on a hot streak of making loops, and I'll save them for a rainy day. So if I don't like them now, I can make something different out of them later, or I can send them to somebody else and maybe that got them inspired. Even though you're not inspired to make a whole beat, who knows what could happen tomorrow or at 6 o'clock, or if you send it to somebody else, maybe it'll get them inspired and maybe you can get a placement out of that. A lot of amazing things happen. Now, the eighth thing that I like to do is meditate. Now, I'm not gonna cap with you. I don't meditate every day. I wish I had the discipline to just meditate every day and all that kind of shit. But, you know, when I do, or when I feel stressed out, I'll just take 100 breaths in and out. And then by the end of it, I'll feel way more in the moment as opposed to thinking about something in the future that I can't control, or something in the past that, you know, it still has me feeling a certain type of way. But after meditating, none of that shit matters. So meditate for 10 minutes, 5 minutes if you feel very fidgety. If you are fidgety or your mind wanders, that's a good thing because that means you're starting to get in control and you're starting to be in the moment. The ninth thing I like to do is use MIDI kits and loop kits. Other people have made samples that they didn't make something out of. So if I hear that, I'm instantly gonna be inspired. I might manipulate them. I might throw them into the FL Slicer, whatever. And then, you know, who knows? It could possibly be placement. It could possibly be trash. All in all, it doesn't matter. As long as you're willing to just try it, that's all that matters. The next thing I like to do is I like to make some trash beats. See, a couple days ago, I was reading Kobe's book, Mamba Mentality. And in the book, he says that he starts at the rim about hand length and then just makes easy shots. And then he backs up a little bit more and then makes some more and makes some more. And even if he misses really close, he tries to get that muscle memory back. The reason why I say make terrible beats is because that can help you out so much, because that's just getting in the groove. And nobody's gonna know but you. So even if you feel like you're trash, even if you feel like you're terrible or this is bad, there's always one good thing out of that bad, terrible beat that you think it is. Listen, I can go on and on and on about this, but personally, I think these are the best ways that you can get out of BeatBlock. And I can keep going on, but I think I'm gonna stop it right here because I wanna know how you guys get out of BeatBlock. So let me know down in the comment section, what are ways that you guys get out of BeatBlock? Hopefully you guys apply these tips and they help you out. You're not trash, you're not as bad as you think you are. You're actually really good at what you do. So hopefully these tips help you out of that rough patch. And I'll see you guys next time. Oh yeah, I'm on Fortnite. I've been killing shit on there.
Oh shit. Nigga, I only have 1% left. Nigga, this is the first time I ever won. Let's fucking go.
So definitely add me on there. So yeah, I'll see you guys next time. And go crazy.
Yes, sir. Go ahead.
Where is it from?
Where is my outfit? Yes, sir. Big drip.